The Learning Journey in association with Turn It Up Tuesday, hosted by Ross Audio, is pleased to present Did You Know? Let me give a call out to my cousin Maurice in New York, who gave me the idea for this week's topic. And this week, we want to move you to North America, where we will explore someone in the United States. This week, we will focus on a great African-American who made her mark in the field of medicine. Her willingness to serve the black community created a legacy that lives on today. So follow me as we explore the life of Rebecca Lee Crumpler, a black female doctor who changed the field of medicine forever. She was born named Rebecca Davis in Delaware on February 8, 1831. Under the supervision of her aunt who lived in Pennsylvania, she would watch her as she cared for others. She gave a tribute to her aunt in her book by writing, "It may be well to state here that having been by a kind aunt in Pennsylvania, whose usefulness with the sick was continually sought, I early conceived a liking for and sought every opportunity to relieve the suffering of others." By 1852, she relocated to the area of Charleston, Massachusetts, to pursue a career in nursing. During this time, she worked with various doctors. Based on her outstanding work with these doctors, she was able to secure various recommendations from them. In 1860, she applied to the New England Female Medical College and was accepted. During this period, Rebecca had two dominant issues in her life. One was she was a female, and that time females experienced a high level of discrimination. The other was that she was black. In her book, she writes, "From its inception, many male physicians derided the institution, complaining that women lacked the physical strength to practice medicine. Others insisted that not only were women incapable of mastering a medical curriculum, and that many of the topics taught were inappropriate for their sensitive and delicate nature." Regardless of these perspectives, Rebecca and her classmates finished their degree. While the three were given the green light to practice, the research shows that there was some hesitation regarding Rebecca's final oral examination. In her journey on Earth, she would witness the negative effects of racism and prejudice on herself and her community. Crumpler felt called to become a doctor to help people of color who face discrimination because of the color of their skin. As a result, she worked hard to become the first African-American woman to receive a medical degree in the United States. Another reason for her decision to study was to ensure that she created a legacy to show black girls in America and around the world that they could have more opportunities in the future. Her mission to serve others was also a difficult one. Many white men saw her as inferior, and the druggist made it difficult for her to fill her prescriptions. And while she had the full qualifications of other doctors in the United States, many believed it was okay to crack a joke as it relates to her qualification, MD, abbreviation. Some said it meant mule driver. How ridiculous and hateful this really is. Dr. Crumpler's academic work titled A Book of Medical Discourse was published in 1833. It made a huge impact in the field of medicine. It was her way of educating others to understand that the black Americans were not merely likely to fall ill or die because of physiological differences than their white counterparts. While Dr. Lee Crumpler made a drastic contribution to the medical field in America and globally, her work would go unrecognized for decades. Therefore, it was quite fitting that in February 2021, Dr. Lee Crumpler was awarded the Certificate of Congressional Recognition by the 18th District of Texas. The citation read, "Now, therefore, be it resolved on behalf of the constituents of the 18th Congressional District of Texas. I take great pride in recognizing Dr. Crumpler on the occasion of National Women's Physician Day. It is my privilege to declare this day, February the 8th, is a National Black Woman's Physician Day in the 18th Congressional District of Texas. You are deserving of our utmost esteem for your gracious contribution, and you are indeed worthy of respect, admiration, and commendations in the United States. While some people might say it has taken a long time to recognize her at this level, I think it's quite fitting for us to reflect on what this individual did and the barriers she broke in order for others to have access. Now let me continue, because I want to highlight a little about her book. Let us get it real. This book was published in 1833. It was set in the context of slavery as well as moving towards emancipation period. It was a time when things were difficult for black people in United States. It was a time, if you were writing, you'd write from the perspective that you have. And that's what she did as she did her work. I believe that her book titled The Book of Medical Discourses gives a great look at the context of time. It gives us a window into the past and how we have changed over time. I will leave you with two quotations from her work in relation to marriage, which you might want to accept, or you might say those are the old days. Quotation 1. She writes, "A man's age should be between 22 and 25 when taking the responsibility of a family upon himself." She continues by saying, "I will just add here that the way to be happy after marriage is to continue in the careful routine of courting days, till it becomes a well-understood thing between the two." What Dr. Crumpler is saying, that you should continue courting till it becomes a well-understood thing between the two. Although you're married, you still should continue. That's kind of sound advice that many should take. Let us look at the second quotation. She says, "Some women are over-anxious for family, and by their nervous whims, make themselves and those around them unhappy." She continues by saying, "But I am to deplore that there is a larger class of young women whose minds are dark on the subject of preservation of health, and will soon forget if they ever thought about the liabilities of a married life." So here she's going on in the first chapter, and she gives and highlights regarding certain things. I found some of her work very contradictory based on our present thought, but as I stated before, she wrote in a time and a context that things were very straight. You were not allowed to mix race and that sort of thing, and you can see that in her work and her thoughts, because at that time, for her, she had no movement across boundaries. She was committed to serve her section of her population, and that was the black people. If you want to know more about her work, I would advise you to read some of the chapters in this book, and the links are on my YouTube channel for you to explore. Let me conclude by saying, Dr. Crumpler died on March 9, 1895. She was laid to rest in Hyde Park. Dr. Rebecca Lee Crumpler was a remarkable woman who lived in a time that was difficult for African Americans in the United States. Women had very few opportunities to get an education, and their career paths were stifled by men who did not allow them to have access. We must remember the contributions of Dr. Rebecca Lee Crumpler. We must remember that the journey to freedom was never easy. And while she got her medical degree and she was called MD, many individuals decided that it was okay to say she was a mule driver based on the abbreviation. We must recognize her efforts, because without her and without her efforts, the journey would have been longer. Remember to visit my YouTube channel again and access this video presentation. in addition to the sources that you will find there. Until next week, over to you, Rossi.